What's good, everybody? More Tales of Berseria with Joshua Jericho. And we are on the island of Ysalt, and we're looking for grimoire, so let's do it.
The people of Southgand originally worshipped Ominoch, the Empyrean of Water. The lives of the people of the Southern Isles are inherently tied to the sea. Whether it was gratitude for a good catch or an appeal for protection, everyone offered their prayers to Ominoch.
But the Abbey worships Anominot, don't they? Do the people still keep their faith?
Most of the people obey the will of the Abbey. But one small village deep in Southgand is a special case. The village is called Haria, and even now they keep their faith in Ominoch. They've even quarreled with the Abbey. I'm grateful that they fight off the demons. I really am. But do they have to dictate which gods we worship to?
They think they do. It's their truth. Then again, they can't control what's in your heart, can they?
Isn't that where the demon is that they were talking about in the last episode? Anominot and Ammonach both offer their blessing to humanity. I want to pray to both to give them my thanks, but... No, do not pray to Anominot. It's a trick. Lady Teresa is an exorcist praetor here from Hellweeds. She was sent here as a sort of punishment, but she put the town in order with a firm death hand. We're sorry to see her go, but she recommended Lord Oscar as her replacement, so we should be fine. Oh, she got sent here as a punishment. I wonder if that punishment was because of Hellweeds getting burned down by us. Or for letting us go. Not letting us go, but like not catching us. Or maybe it was for letting Lopiset get away. A lot of options. Take your pick, I guess. I need your kitty litter so that I can get them boxes of cats. Boxes of cats. Enough, Batoro. Wait, is that them over there? Is that Oscar? Yeah, that's Oscar. Right over there. How did he get over there? He's so much more agile than I am. Look, there's not even a way up there. You plan to be a fisherman when you're older, do you? Nope, I'm gonna captain my own ship. Don't be daft. Every fisherman is a captain. Even if his ship is a bit small. Yeah, don't be daft. What?
What does it mean to become an adult?
The eternal question of youth.
Have you ever heard of the ceremony of adulthood? It's a yearly tradition on this island.
If I remember right, it's totally wild. Everyone throws bananas and porringes at each other.
Traditionally, yes, but things have changed over the years. Bananas and porringes are a thing of the past. People are always reaching for bigger and better things, right? In this case, it's watermelons. Whole watermelons.
You're throwing watermelons? That's gotta hurt.
Trust me, I know. But watermelons are the least of our worries. Recently, people have started flinging coconuts.
Coconuts? Those things are as hard as rocks!
Trust me, I know. Like getting hit with a brick. Now, every year, there are some kids who never make it to adulthood.
You don't mean they...
Yeah, I've kept putting it off myself, but it looks like this year, I've got no choice but to participate. That's crazy. It's far too dangerous. And more importantly, how does it make someone an adult?
There are ancient traditions that say overcoming danger marks a child's coming of age. Some people still cling to the old ways.
You've hit the nail on the head. There are lots of old folks that sit around complaining how weak us darn kids are. The hypocrites. Back then, they used bananas and watermelons. They even cracked the watermelons ahead of time.
I don't think cracking a coconut would help much either.
So that's why you're standing about looking blue.
I'm so ashamed of myself for being scared.
If you don't want to do the ceremony, why not just skip it?
I'd love to, but I don't really have a choice. I wouldn't be able to show my face around here if I chickened out.
Having the courage to say no to something you don't feel is right. Isn't that the true mark of an adult?
Wait.
You're right! Now I can finally become an adult! Oh, yeah! Look how grown up I am!
And getting carried away with yourself and acting the fool is the true mark of immaturity.
Sorry. You're right.
Becoming an adult is too much hard work. How? If they... Okay, the first time a kid doesn't survive that because he gets decked in the head by a coconut and killed, wouldn't the responsible adults on the island be like, we are never, ever using coconuts again. Ever. That'd be the end of it, right? You'd nip that in the bud. The ocean's been receding bit by bit for 10 years, and currents don't have the pool they used to. It's almost like nature's power is dwindling. I don't like it one bit. Do you think it could be Aminok's curse on us? Probably. You're that card game again. I'll pass for now. Backwater Beach is through the gate. It used to be a paradise for penguins and visitors alike. Now it's a place where demons stalk visitors and send them to paradise. If you plan on passing through, tread carefully. Penguins! Can I talk to the penguins? Nope. Can't even touch. Oh yeah, I can touch them, but... Some penguins, they just sit there.
Penguin, 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 penguin.
Okay, I need to get back up top, I think. That doesn't work. Going this way. Did you hear about Haria Village? There's a real nasty demon over there. Even the exorcists aren't able to handle it. Weren't they the ones who disobeyed the Abbey and kept worshiping their old gods? Sounds like they got what was coming to them. Yeah. How dare you live your own life and do things your own way. Domesticated penguin has a docile flavor compared to wild penguin. Wild penguin has a lot of personality. It's rowdy all the way down.
What?
I guess that would be kind of like the argument of like free-range chicken versus regular chicken, but with penguins. Sure. New stuff. Dang, lots of new stuff. I have three of those. I love when they give me one pair of boots. I have one boots. Like, everybody can fight over it. Thanks! I was just exactly hoping for that I could have everybody fight over the boots. You read my mind. You're the best.
Hey, this doll? It looks like Bienfu.
Ah, a keen eye you have, young man. That is a doll of the Empyrean Ominoch.
That's... Empyrean Ominoch?
Yep, no doubt about it. I've seen her with my own eyes. Real dignified, but not without a bit of a temper.
You saw her? Why was she angry?
Well, the Abbey's banned any profession of the Ominochian faith in Southgand, despite her popularity. Gotta assume that's what got her all bent out of shape. I tried talking to her, but no matter what I said, she was just like, oh.
Wait, that sounds like... And that low-energy goddess you saw? The doll you've got here looks like her?
Yeah, more or less.
Ha! Fortune smiles upon thee, weary adventurers. That listless goddess is none other than Grim.
Grimoire isn't human?
When did I ever say she was? So, shopkeep, where'd you see her?
I think it was down by McClear Beach.
Pensively watching the tide come in? That's her, all right. Quickly, to the beach!
Why didn't you mention Grimoire as a Moloch before now?
You can't be too careful with that information. Spies, spies listening everywhere!
I saw the great Ammonok at Maclear Beach look just like this figurine. If you see Ammonok around, just say I'm a huge personal fan, alright? So it looks like this little... So her friend... Wait. Is Mogilu an Empyrean? That doesn't make sense though, because why would she need the info? But who makes friends with Empyreans? Like, it's no big deal. That is intriguing. I'm intrigued now. Intriguiness has filled me. Well, this is the beach.
Beautiful waters. So this is Maclear Beach.
I hope she's actually here.
Me too, kid. Me too.
Don't waste my time.
No escape! Take that!
Devour!
You won't get away!
Hurricane Crusher!
Hurricane! Shake the heavens! Here goes!
Hurricane Crusher! Shooting star!
No escape!
See this? Deception!
No escape! Tip-tap! Burning moon! No escape!
This sucks. I don't like him.
Your style is really unique.
Just wait until I pull out the good stuff.
Yeah.
I won't run away.
No escape.
I got nagas and sea cucumbers and squids. Status element poison. I bet it does damage over time. You think the poison does damage over time? What is that thing?
I can bite too.
No escape.
I did good, didn't I?
Treasure! Cat,
I did good, didn't I?
Did fine.
On to battle. For two!
No escape! Dark and
light! Show!
Really tough!
Wall of armor!
Burning Moon! Spirit release! You've wronged me! Here's your justice! Finding order!
Have some justice! Free on the house!
You're not hurt, are you?
No, I'm fine.
I really don't like cat boxes anymore. It went from being weird, but okay, to being not okay.
This grimoire who we're searching for is a Moloch like Bienfu, right? To be honest, I don't see how someone so different can be a Moloch just the same as Lafayette or Aizen.
I understand your doubts. It's quite the tangly mess.
I'll tell you anything!
In that case, I've been wondering, what's underneath your hat?
Oh no! Anything but that!
So, we've hit a wall already.
But that ribbon flaps around and gets in the way, right? Could I take it off for you?
No! No! That's not possible! You mustn't remove the ribbon!
Why not?
That's another thing I can't say!
It's all cans with you. Alright, is there anything you can tell me?
I could talk about what type of Malakim we are, or our position in the world of Malakim, or our abilities.
Oh, I'd like to know all that.
Then I will tell you. Listen closely. We Norman are a well-established race of Malakim. Compared to other Malakim, we aren't as adept at manipulating natural forces, but we excel at drawing out and heightening the abilities of others.
Think of them as a convenient power-up.
They're also known as common spirits.
Don't even say that! We Norman hate being called that!
Why is it so painful for you?
Because it makes people think we're average and unremarkable! That's why we work so hard to show how we're all different!
That does explain your quirky speaking mannerisms.
Don't sweat it. That's a perfectly common thing to worry about.
Don't say that!
Why did I not figure out that he was a Norman before? Norman are like what cats were in the Zestiria game, where you would like run around and like, not run around, but you had to like find and unlock Norman. And some of them were characters too, but like, you tried to earn the favor of the Normans and they would give you special powers and...
Right then, let's finish this!
So she's not actually an Empyrean, she's a Norman? Does that mean that she pretends to be an Empyrean? Or that the Empyreans aren't real? I wonder what that is.
This fight is over!
That presents some interesting quandaries.
What are those penguins doing?
Probably keeping their eggs warm.
Most likely. They look like a mama and a papa. Penguins are monogamous, faithful creatures. They never leave their mate. Isn't that romantic?
So they lay eggs because they're like husband and wife. But how do they make the eggs?
That's... well...
So, Luffy said, here's an interesting fact. A single penguin egg actually contains dozens of smaller orange eggs.
Oh, so their eggs must be small and crunchy.
Yep, they have the texture of caviar and the rich flavor of sea urchins.
Interesting. So they're more like fish than birds.
So you've eaten them. How cruel. Look how much they care about their young.
While it may be a bit cruel, they taste amazing. They're considered a delicacy in some circles. Top a bowl of rice with these crunchy eggs and some rich penguin thigh meat, and you get a dish called family fricassee.
That's a horrific name.
I wasn't the one who named it, okay?
Those eggs look tasty, but I think I'll pass.
That's a horrid name! You're talking about the egg and then the mama's thigh meat on top of it? Or, well, maybe not the mama's thigh meat. Maybe the daddy's. Maybe it's the daddy's thigh meat. How is there any good... Neither one of those is a good option, really. It's just horrible. Who named that family fricassee? Oh, it's awful. And what's funny about it is, it's really not... is it really, really terrible? I mean... Velvet's just giving Eleanor a hard time, because... When Eleanor, or when Velvet was pre-demon, I mean, she ate raw pig, right? So... It's not... all... I mean, how many of those... Ores did we kill at the beginning of the game so that she could earn money and turn them into meat, right? Like, it's not that different. She's just picking on Eleanor. But that is a horrible name for a food item that involves the child and the parent on the same meal token. That is a pretty awful name.
When I'm this close, I won't miss! Form Zero! Thunder!
I refuse to fall here.
Featherlight steps. Yay, more boots.
I'll end this quickly.
No escape!
Double head! Deception!
Claws of Auburn! No escape! Shutter!
Get it
started! Clear off!
Deception! Double head! I'll stop you! Next!
I feel like Eleanor is never going to get a break in this game. It's just been pretty much making fun of her since minute one that she showed up in the game. Like calling her a crybaby and stuff.
Victory is ours!
Don't waste my time.
No escape!
Jade Way! Jade Way!
Take the
dice! Jade Way! See this?
Is that all you got?
Here! Here! One way! Here! Watch it! Out of my way!
I won't go easy on you!
Crash through!
I did it!
No escape! No escape!
Soaring Dragon! Shut up!
I still need a lot of training. Is training hard? It's necessary, so no, I don't think so.
Classic honor roll student.
She can learn cute shoes. She could learn amber boots and battle boots. Well, sure, you can learn amber boots. You're not actually in the battle right now, so I'm going to allow it.
Is that
Grimoire? She's moving away!
No escape!
A dragon?
No, just a big lizard demon.
Is he friends with Dial?
Spirits, release!
You've wronged me! Here's your justice! Binding order!
Why would you just assume his friends with Dial?
No mercy! Wounds that won't heal! Carved into flesh! Lethal pay! No escape!
See this? Double hate!
Splatter!
I'll stop you! I'll stop you! Double hate!
Here I come! Yes! Syringat! Twin whip! Tip-ta!
Shooting star!
Tip-ta!
No escape!
Shield down! Pierce! Tip-ta! Tip-ta!
Double hate! Double hate!
Armor crusher!
Was a close one, but I am the victor.
Rising Falcon? That sounds fun. Grants a random skill that creates an advantage against amorphous, modius, beast, crustacean, and winged enemies on normal mode or above.
So she's the same sort of Moloch as Bianfu?
Your grimoire, right? We've been looking for you. We need your help.
Who are you?
I'm Velvet. I know your witch friend.
Oh.
Grim, so wonderful to see you.
It's been forever!
Ah, you two. Still as outlandish a pair as ever, I see.
How exactly do you know her?
Witch training? She was an upperclassman.
And?
We found this fascinating ancient tome, and we were hoping you could read it for us.
Goodness, Magilu. You, of all people, joining a team? I didn't know you had it in you.
They keep me entertained.
Well, I don't need entertainment.
Bien! Come on, Grim! Isn't there any way you can help us?
It's not the kind of thing I do.
Oh, what a shame. Things happen. Well, we tried, didn't we?
Maybe you need some incentivizing.
Do it.
I'm serious.
I bet you are. Your eyes tell me you're dangerous. Trouble follows you like a hawk tails a rabbit. And at my age, trouble is something I'd rather avoid.
How old are you?
Ask me again and you'll get a firework in the tush.
My apologies.
It appears we've wasted our time.
A walk on the beach is never wasted, but sorry.
Well, how did you learn to read the ancient tongue? Are there books for studying it or something?
My, my. Are you actually thinking of learning it on your own?
Well, I love reading, and I want to learn more about history. Besides, we need what's in this book.
You have passion, child. I'll give you that.
Not to mention you want to be helpful to Velvet, don't you, kid?
Yeah.
My tuition isn't cheap, you know.
You will teach me?
No, I won't. But I admire your dedication enough to read it for you. Now where's this book?
Here it is, ma'am.
You needn't be so formal.
Yes, ma'am. Not ma'am. Right.
Let's see what we're looking at here. The language of ancient Averrost. Had to be the hard one, of course. A lot of wear and tear, too. This'll take some time.
We're in a hurry.
That may well be, but this isn't the place for study. Let's move to someplace more comfortable.
You've redeemed yourself, young man. There's a village called Haria just a little ways away.
That works. Thank you.
Fine. Haria Village. Whatever gets the job done.
I apologize if I'm being rude, but I have to ask. You're not Ominoch the Empyrean, are you?
Of course I'm not. What would even make you ask such a thing?
A shop in Isolt was selling Ominoch figurines that looked just like you.
Oh, that. I distinctly remember whispering to the shopkeeper in his sleep, telling him not to sell those things.
You showing up in his dreams probably only convinced him you were the real deal! You should sue for his use of your likeness and get proper compensation from that shopkeeper!
Forget it. It's no concern.
Yeah, you're right. It's not like they'd ever sell anyway.
Oh, you think a figurine of mine wouldn't sell?
You got this whole somber ennui thing going on. A figurine needs to be cute, like me.
Then how about I turn you into a product?
Me? Really?
Oh, yes. I'll have you stuffed and mounted. But since it'd be a unique piece, I'd have to price it a bit higher.
Mounted? No, no, count me out!
Oh, you're no fun. Now, what was it we were talking about?
Whether or not you are the Empyrean Ominoch.
Ah, yes, that's right. I'm no Empyrean. I'm just a simple girl. It would be hard for anyone to worship an Empyrean like me, right?
That's true. It just seems like you're the type who can see through anything, so perhaps an Empyrean seems less intimidating from a certain point of view.
You're saying I'm scarier than an Empyrean?
Not scarier, exactly. Just more of a savvy sort of woman.
That's not a bad answer. But it won't get you out of the doghouse.
Okay, well, on that note, we'll stop here and we will head to the city Haitia on the next episode. Maybe get a Code Red monster down there on the map. So, look forward to that. At least one answer. At least we got one answer. Well, run away from that guy. Don't get in a fight. Save that for later. All right. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time.